Hello and welcome to this week's Weekly Hack. My name is Steve Durham. Today is May the 5th, and we're going to be talking about some of the normal questions and answers that we get. Parts orders can be sent to parts@jcsteele.com, and don't forget that you can save 2% on your wear parts when you order online. Also, you can find previously recorded weekly hacks on our LinkedIn page or on the YouTube playlist, and the links are provided here. If you have questions or just need more information, you can send your request to asksteele@jcsteele.com. We'll get those directed to the proper people and get that information gathered and sent it back to you. We get asked about locations of parts, such as the pump here. So everything can be installed absolutely correctly, but if it's put in the wrong environment, then they're sure to fail. Under leaky conveyor belts is not a good place to store your pump, and you can see how this one gets covered up and it'll cause your seals and all to go bad. When installing parts, pay attention to the direction they're facing. It's easy to get them turned around and in the machine. In some instances, this could cause problems. Here you can see the wedge pattern in two different directions, and you want to make sure that their wedge pattern is made so it's actually squeezing the material in towards the auger. Why and what is the proper installation of the knife? So in the photo to the left, you can see the wear on the top edge here, and this is due to the knife being pitched too aggressive. Not only is it dangerous to have your knife worn like this, but it's also wearing into the shank. This weakens the shank in the bolt, causing it to fail later on. So if you notice in the drawing to the right, that the frame and square is against the edge of the pug tub, or you can see a 1/8 inch offset. So this is pitching your blade back towards the back of the bulkhead, away from the square, and this is where it's picking it up and pulling the material forward. 1/8 inch pitch is the correct way to set this. Why am I leaking oil out of the back of the gearbox? You normally see this whenever the breathers on the top inspection cover are getting clogged. So you want to make sure you keep those breathers inspected, keep them clean, and keep that pressure from building inside the gearbox. Once it gets clogged up, the pressure builds, and that's what causes your leak. And a lot of times you may see a lot of silicone between the castings back there. Another question we get is, why is material leaking out of the back of my pug tub? So this is where the labyrinth seal is. This has to be greased every 4 hours. So if you start seeing material build up on the back or dropping out of the back of your pug tub, then that seal is not being greased enough. So you'll have to change the castings, re-grease it, make sure it seals it off. But keeping it greased is the key. We're often asked, what grease do we recommend? And per our lubrication chart, we recommend an EP or extreme pressure lithium-based grease. It has an NLGI consistency of number 2, a bearing load range of 40 or more, and do not use all-purpose grease or ball bearing grease. Another question we have is, are there tools to help you change your augers and liners? And yes, we do have them. So here you see in the drawings, we have the auger installation tools for both the 90 and the 75. This extends the shaft out past so you can get the auger started on there. The key way is to help line it up, and you can slide them back and get it up over that little lip in the back. We also offer liner adapter installations. So if you have a 90, the two key pieces, looks like little T's up there, that's what's bolted to the front of the barrel, and it helps extend the keyway out. So whenever you're trying to line up your adapters with the liners in them on your 90, this helps, and you can slide them back in. It's especially helpful if you have a hydride diatomizer in place. Here you go. Why is the material level in the pug high in some places and low in others? So in this video, you can see how it's low in the back, and then it builds as it's getting up towards the sealant auger at the front. So your knives are probably pitched a little aggressive in the back, so it's pushing material up forward quicker than it should be. So your retention time is what you're looking for in your pug sealer. That's what's happened to mix your clay and water together. So you need to go back and check the pitch on those knives if you see this in your pug tub. If you've noticed that you have hard caking, especially like between the auger and the liner, and you want to know what can you do about that. So typically what we do is first we recommend that you switch to a spiral liner. That helps the clay to flow on out of the barrel itself. And if this is not something that helps out the hard caking, then we may actually recommend that you go with a lubrication system, such as one that you put either in the barrel itself or up at the pug tub. So when you're changing your pug shanks, and people ask, what's the proper torque, or is there a torque on these shanks? Yes, there is. So you want to make sure that once you get those set and get them pitched correctly, that you torque those down to 225 foot-pounds. So this is the shank and the aluminum bushing and the little cap screw that's down there. So you want to make sure you torque it to the proper setting. So why is my column swelling? Well, there can be a couple different factors here. One thing to check, and this is a quick check, is make sure that your core tips is not sticking out past the end of the shaper cap. They should be set. We recommend a 16th inside to flush. If you get too far back, then you may see that it's shrinking. Too far out, you may see it swelling. Another factor is low vacuum. You can see more swelling if you have lower vacuum. Another question we get is, why is my column not coming out straight out of the die? So one thing you need to make sure that you're checking is that your lubrication pump is pumping correctly. Make sure your lines are open. And if all that checks out, then you're going to have to open up the back of the die and inspect where the oil imports are. Whether it's if it's our die, you have two separate oil imports. You have the one in the very back at the oil ring in the rear and at the mid base. So if you have either one of those clogged or that your wear plate is worn so much that it's causing the flow of the oil to go wherever it wants to, you may see this. Another question is, why does the column continue to move after I stop the machine? So once you disengage your clutch, you need to make sure that you hear that air disengage quickly. If it goes out slowly, then your column is going to coast, and that's kind of dangerous, especially if you got someone down the line. Make sure you go back and check those quick exhaust valves. You can check on them and get those rebuild kits and get those changed out. Very inexpensive. Can some parts be installed incorrectly? Yes, they can. As we mentioned in one of the earlier slides, especially the cylinder auger on your pug, if it gets turned 180 degrees out, then what it does is it does not line up with the first knife that actually picks up the material and pulls it into the auger itself. And this could cause you to have backup in the pug tub and not get enough into the extruder. Using your ordering chart, so after all your parts have been pulled out, you make sure that you line all your parts up on the floor as they go in. This would help with the confusion of which auger goes next or what liner goes next. So if you lay those out, that will help you when you're actually installing all the parts back again. Will you come and work on our machine? Yes, we have field service technicians that will come and perform mechanical rebuilds if you don't feel comfortable doing it yourself. It's a good idea to test your material for particle size measurements. The National Brick Research Center at Clemson University will help you do that. You can contact those folks and they'll get that test run for you. Listed here are our partners' websites where you can find more information as well. We're part of a large group, so you can contact us for any of your needs. We're here to help. I'd like to thank you for joining us today, and if you have any questions, please don't hesitate to contact us and send us by email, or you can just give us a call. Thank you very much.